day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast laser project. So let's get cracking. Friends, today is going to be kind of cool. We're going to use the Laserman from Flying Bear and the Comgrow Z1 at the exact same time. All right, friends, so this is some 5mm stock from some old pallets, and we're going to use that to make some keychains. Let me show you how we set it up on the computer. Friends, the first thing I want you to understand about this process is you want to open Lightburn twice. You want to have both laser cutters on. You can see I've got the Z1, and it says it's connected to 10. Let's hit home, and that worked just like it's supposed to. The second one is the Flying Bear Laserman, and it's connected to COM 8. I'm going to hit home on that, and it's working exactly like it's supposed to as well. So now I'm going to maximize this one because I've got a larger cut on the Z1. We're going to do File, we're going to do Open, and we're looking for my four Mount Pisgah keychains. When you load this, you can see that there are four keychains right here. It is going to go from the origin that's down here in the left-hand corner. That's easy for me to line up. I'll show you that on camera in a moment. I also want to show you that we're going to do 420 for the speed, 100% for the power, and then we're going to fill in these cool letters on the image, 3360 power. I'm going to run it through five times just so that I'm sure that it cuts all the way through. And now, friends, let's get it all lined up. I'm just going to remind you, these are my custom wires that hold it in place. They are still working like a champ. If we switch to the move command, let's see if I've got this already at the right height. I can't remember exactly what my last project was. It is definitely these keychains, so that's perfect. I'm going to come one to the right, and let's hit frame and see how this looks. It was a little bit low, and it ran into that wire. We can back that up just a little bit. I'm going to twist that over. Let's reconnect it. I'm going to have it move over one so that way I can get it in place. Now let's do shift nudge to move that back. I am running into that wire, so I'm going to go over one more chunk. And now let's try that frame one more time. You can see I'm cutting right through the middle of that piece of wood, and it's hitting on this side. That's because this piece is popped out. So I'm going to pop this back under the foot so it holds that down. Make sure I've got it aligned. Do a couple of control nudges over, and I'm going to do a control nudge down. One more frame. Let's check that. Stayed on the wood the whole way. Friends, that's looking really good. So now on this one, I'm going to plug in my tiny fan in the back. Notice now we've got my custom vent. That is working. You can double check out that video. I'll make sure I have that in the corner. I'm going to close the enclosure in a second, but right now let's hit start and let's make something magical. All right, friends, so there you've got a peek of it doing the cut through the glass. Absolutely love the way this enclosure works. You can see there is smoke in there, but there is no smoke in my room, which is absolutely amazing. Now, friends, I am going to set up the other one. I'm going to stop this part of the video, and let me show you the other project. So we're actually doing two things at once. All right, so note that this is a 20-minute plus project, and that's another reason why it's awesome to have two lasers connected at the same time. So right now I'm going to move to the second laser, and this is where I would do the backs of these keychains. Now right now, since I've got 20 minutes, I'm going to save that and let's open up a different project, and let's actually cut an entire keychain on the laser. Here is my Flying Bear 1 keychain project. If we double check our settings, this laser I do 280 and 100, once again 4 passes. And then I'm going to do the fill of 3370. Let's get someone set up and let's make this cut as well. Friends, once again, I'm going to start from that bottom corner. Let's move out there with the nudge. I'm going to use shift nudge to move out to the piece of wood. I've got this further out than I normally would, just because I want to make sure that you have got a view of where it's at. Once again, friends, I am close, but this one is not quite. I must have done something different, or I've got thicker wood. I have taken to using this and a few little shims, and it seems to get me the exact height a little better. As I tighten this down, I'm noticing that it's too tight. Once I pull it out, now if I slide this back in, it fits just the way I want. So I'm just using three of these little metal shims to get it right. And then once again, one of my favorite things is we can store that right back where it goes. So let's adjust our alignment. I'm gonna go left, down, do a couple of control nudges. Let's hit frame and see how this looks. I can move down a couple more. Let's do control nudge again. One more frame, just because it's better safe than sorry. I think I can still go down one more. That one I like. So now let's grab some safety glasses and let's make something magical. Alrighty, so there is our keychain. Let's see if it came all the way through. No, it didn't. That is a bummer, but watch this. I have found I can rescue these by clipping with pliers, and quite often I can get right down to the bottom of where it was and still turn out all right. Now this one's gonna be a problem because I got in a hurry and I broke it off. So you can see it was that close to cutting all the way through. Probably one more pass and I would have been groovy. Once I've got it close, then I come back here and I snip it with these to finish it off. All right, friends, so the other laser is still busy cutting them out. I am just gonna leave these because they are just for fun. Friends, let's get it lined up and I'll show you how we do the back. Now, friends, I got a special spot for this one. See this edge? I know that if I line this up, I can get it lined up pretty darn quick and straight, just like this. So first I'm going to hit home. I'm going to do a shift nudge to move it up, and I'm going to do a shift nudge to move it over, and then I'm just going to dial it in. I'm going to hit a frame from right here so we can see how close. Notice we got to come over about two clicks. I'm going to do control down one click. Let's do another frame to double check. Friends, that's it. And then bingo, let's label the back of our awesome keychain. And there you have it, friends, my Mount Pisgah HLModTech keychain. How cool is that? And at almost the same time, There's our finished ones on this laser. Smoke is dissipated pretty decent. Let's pull them out and see how well these came out. Ooh, that is just how I like them. Friends, we have got wicked cool keychains, and now I'm ready to put the backs on them.
Whenever I want to. Friends, I hope you enjoyed this project. The one thing I do want to remind you is make sure that you have opened Lightburn twice and have both laser cutters connected when you do this. If you are already cutting with one and you launch Lightburn and connect a second laser, it'll likely stop the original project. And I can promise you I learned that the hard way. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.